code analysis is a feature initially released in V.25 and since has seen strong customer adoption. In V.29, we are releasing enforcement, a much requested feature where the lead developer can set thresholds for code quality that are enforced when the developer checks in the code. This provides assurance and governance controls that code quality standards are in place from the beginning of the automation development lifecycle. Marcus, a professional developer, is the lead developer and is responsible for improving the quality of the automation code. Marcus creates code analysis policies that identify and block poor coding practices. This protects the production environment from lower quality and less maintainable code. Once Marcus sets the policies, he assigns them to different coding projects. Marcus has the flexibility to create policies that promote code quality based on the level of expertise that the developers working on different projects have. This enables his organization to utilize developers with different levels of experience and business process know-how to create automations. More available developers means a larger pipeline of automations. As the code quality lead, Marcus has permissions to create and assign code analysis policies. He creates a policy which will detect basic coding problems. Marcus then assigns the policy to the folders for the projects he knows are being worked on by citizen developers. All automation files in this folder path will be evaluated by code analysis using this policy. Marcus understands that citizen developers know their business processes, but are still novices at building automations. His policy will assure that the code developed in the project's folders will meet basic coding best practices. The COE depends on professional developers to review and finish automations before they go to production. To ensure that best practices are enforced, Marcus coordinates with Jake, the automation admin, to make sure the citizen developer roles have the proper permissions for code analysis enforcement on check-in. Jake reviews and updates the permissions for the citizen developer roles. He makes sure that enable enforcement for bot check-in permission is the only permission enabled. This ensures that the members of this role will only be able to check in automation files that do not have either low severity or high severity violations. Sue, a citizen developer, is creating a basic automation. She makes her final edit and saves the automation. Sue then checks in the automation. She provides a comment and reviews the dependencies and clicks on the check-in button. Because Marcus has configured a policy and with enforcement permission set on the role that Sue is a member of, she cannot check in the automation because it has code analysis violations. She is presented with a helpful error message indicating that she cannot check in the files with any code analysis violations. Sue cancels the check-in. Sue remembers now that Marcus had discussed in their team meeting that they would start enforcing code quality standards and that she can use the assistant in the bot editor to get guidance on coding best practices. She opens the automation in the editor and using the assistant fixes the violations. Sue now checks in the automation file successfully, as it has no code analysis violations. Sue now knows that her automation code meets the code quality standards set by Marcus. As a citizen developer, Sue has used her knowledge of the business process to submit her automation. Marcus ensures that the automation is reviewed and made ready for production by an experienced professional developer who is held to higher coding standards with policies that are more stringent and checks for more complex coding practices. The automation is now ready for production.